Hi everyone! This is part 2 in a collection of ideas that I think they are not very standard, but I think they are worth knowing. So in this case I'm going to talk about Varimax rotation and hierarchical clustering on principal components. You can go back to the first part of the video if you want to learn more about reconstructed data, quality representation, and how to use supplementary elements and why is that useful. Let's talk about the Varimax rotation. So one of the problems with PCA is that sometimes if you don't know the problem very well, which is actually always a bad idea, but imagine that you are in charge of some data set and you are not an expert in the variables there. So you have something like this. So this is the breast cancer data set. You have a lot of variables that you can see that they are correlated with dimension 1 and some of them are correlated with dimension 2. But you cannot tell what's the meaning of those variables because according to this, the representation, you almost have a continuum of representation, a continuum of quality of representation in each of those variables. So in this case, you can see that PCA1 is a scale factor or a size factor, is the other name that we gave to that, meaning that all the variables are represented in that dimension. So it's not a very good variable if you want to classify each variable. Actually, looking at the first column of dimension 1 in this correlation diagram, you can see that almost all the cycles are blue and large. And the problem is that it's not that this is a scale factor. The problem is that you have tons of variables which are large. So you cannot tell. So you could create groups of variables, but all of them are almost relevant to understand PC1. The idea of Varimax rotation is the following. So imagine that you have decided how many components you need. So imagine that you have one or two components to describe all the variants. And then Varimax rotation tries to maximize not the variance of each component, but the sum of the squares of the loadings. Okay, this is a kind of rich regularization, but I'll leave that for another day. So the advantage of this idea is that it provides components which are strongly correlated with certain variables and completely uncorrelated with the others. So basically we are going to try to find the way in which we can maximize some of the variables and leave the correlations apart for the other variables. There are some disadvantages. One is that the solutions do not maximize the projected variance, so now the components are not optimal, so we have to choose in advance the number of PCs, and the problem is that changing that number is going to change the final rotated principal component. So let me show you an example. Well, the bad news is that Factomine R doesn't incorporate this idea of Varimax rotation, but we can use the library psych. The idea is really simple, so we have to pre-select in advance the number of factors that we want to rotate, and now we call this function principal. So let's plot the correlation diagram for the case in which we are not using Varimax rotation and the case that we are. So it looks more or less the same, but you can see that you have more gaps in the data, so you have less large cycles. And that means that these gaps are close to zero, but not one or minus one, and somewhere in the middle. And the same for the second principal component. So you can see here that we have a lot of, let's say, reddish cycles. And in this case, because of this rotation, almost all the cycles are equally sized, and we don't have almost any variable that could provide an ambiguous interpretation. So now the data is going to be much simpler to interpret. Now, if you look at the byplot, you can see that effect. So you can see now that you have a lot of arrows which are clustered together around the horizontal axis, and more vertical arrows which are clustered around the vertical axis. We still have some variables which are could be misleading, but at least we have increased our interpretability. So we have created more gaps between the horizontal and the vertical axis. And this is going to improve the interpretability of the data. And finally, and you're going to love this one, HCPC, which is hierarchical clustering on principal components, which is a fancy name to say that you first are going to compute principal components and then perform hierarchical clustering. So let me show you an example again. If you go back to the videos on clustering, we started with some example with the USARS dataset, and we have some states that were clustered together, and actually you can see a projection of that. But the good thing now is that instead of doing the clustering and then project to visualize the cluster, we are going to do the opposite. First, we are going to project into dimensions, and now we're going to cluster together. If you take a look at the variables, you can see that urban population is highly correlated with the vertical axis, with the second principal component, and rape, assault, and murder are highly correlated with the first dimension. So now take a look at this diagram, you could say that states which are high in the second score, high in the second principal component, sorry, are higher urban population or higher rural population. And the states which are higher in the first dimension are going to be higher criminality, and lower in the first dimension, lower criminality. So now we have a clear-cut picture of what's the data talking about. Now, HCPC basically was trying to take those principal components, the result of the principal component, and do a hierarchical clustering. So you can plot a dendrogram, and the algorithm of HCPC is telling us that probably the best choice is splitting in four groups, which are the four colors here. Of course, if you take a look at this dendrogram, we could say that the highest jump is over there, so probably cutting into clusters is good enough, which is the thing that we did before. But the good thing with this is that somehow this is not maximizing information, it's not maximizing separability. And principal components in this case are maximizing variance, so these four clusters are more representative than the two clusters that we would obtain if we cut in these two branches. Okay, let's take a look at this, at the outcome. I'm going to plot the clusters, and now you can see that I'm using this palette because it's more fancy, but again, the idea is that instead of having a couple of big clusters, this principal component is clearly splitting, and the good thing is that you can see a lot of gaps between the clusters. So that's a very good representation of the data. So this is completely different of what we did before. Before, basically, we started doing clustering, and then we use principal components, and you can see now what's the meaning of these dimensions there. We use principal components just for representing the data, for representing the cluster. But here we are projecting the data into principal components, but the cluster was pre-done, let's say, with all the information before. Of course, now the sky is the limit, so you can use hierarchical clustering, or you can use PAM, or you can use K-means, or wherever you want. But the good idea of the message of this part is that it's convenient to start doing some principal component before doing some clustering. Okay, in this case, this has worked smoothly because you can see that the correlation diagram, you have a strong correlation. Of course, the method is not going to improve basic clustering if the variables are not correlated. So in order to have to extract all the benefits of this method, you need, let's say, a matrix like this. You need a correlation diagram in which you have large cycles here and there. And the other good news is that you have another shiny application for HCPC, so you can do this sort of analysis interactively using your mouse and clicking here and there. Finally, I cannot resist to tell you that because you have this separation between urban population, rape, assault, and murder, Varimax rotation in this case is going to work really nicely. So probably Varimax rotation are going to cluster these arrows together and are going to move this urban population to this direction. So as an exercise, you can try to combine both methods and try to see if clustering improves or not.